Morning everyone, I'm Soph, these are my notes, and turns out that growing your own cells is expensive and difficult, which is weird because we spend our whole lives growing cells that make up our bodies, but when you want to grow some sans body, things get a bit tricky. Nevertheless, there are scientists out there who are dedicating their lives to growing all sorts of cells for all sorts of reasons, a process known as tissue engineering. From lab-grown meat being shaped into lab-grown burgers, to skin grafts being made to treat patients. From having a replica set of cells that you can then test out different drugs on, to bioprinting a whole bladder which is then implanted into someone. There's loads of different applications that tissue engineering can have, but it's not all plain sailing though. Lab-grown cells are still in their early stages, especially in terms of their real-life medical applications. There was a bit of a scandal around some lab-grown semi-synthetic tracheas, or windpipes, that were implanted into people and then caused issues not long after. Turns out growing an implantable windpipe was trickier than expected. In order to grow cells in a lab, you need to start with some seed cells, which may come, for example, from the patient that you're then going to want to treat. Then you try and recreate the growth conditions that those cells would need to grow in normal life. If you manage to get those cells to replicate or divide, then they could grow into a tissue. So for example, lots of muscle cells together grow into muscular tissue. If you can then grow lots of different types of tissues, you can combine them to make organs. This is like the Russian doll system of how humans are built. We're made of different organ systems, which are made out of different organs, which are made out of different tissues, which are made out of bunches of cells. But recreating the right conditions for tissue growth is a bit of a pain. Tissues aren't just loads of cells next to each other, they're all interconnected by something called the extracellular matrix. Science word, extracellular matrix, aka the ECM. The ECM is basically a scaffold that cells hold onto, and it's important for giving bundles of cells structure, so influencing their kind of mechanical characteristics, but also controlling chemical interactions between them. So in order to grow your seed cells into something more than just a blob of cells, you're going to need to provide them with some sort of structure to follow, a scaffold to grow around. You also need to give them other stuff like the right chemicals for growth, etc. But it is the scaffold that is important for this video. These cell scaffolds need to have a few different features. For example, they need to be holy so that the cells can grow like through and around them, and they can't have any negative effect on the cells themselves, which kind of makes sense. Themselves. There's a pun in there somewhere, but I can't be bothered finding it. The scaffolds can be removable by surgery, or they can be biodegradable so that cells eventually grow and replace the scaffold. Pause. Edit Sophie here. Scaffolds can be removed because when the cells grow into tissues, they kind of produce their own extracellular matrix. So once the cells have had a chance to grow and kind of become a more tissue-like structure, then the scaffold isn't necessarily needed anymore. Cool. But they don't actually have to be either, and there's pros and cons to all these different routes depending on what you're growing. If you're trying to grow a burger, for instance, then the scaffold should definitely either be degradable or edible. So as you can already tell, it's a really interesting challenge to try and pick the correct materials, which is why this is called tissue engineering. Engineering is exactly what it is, except you're building scaffolding for cells rather than like scaffolding for buildings. So loads of different scaffolds have been developed, and how many times am I going to say scaffold in this video? There are completely synthetic ones made of like silicone, gelatin's an option. One of my favourite routes actually involves taking someone's donor tissue, removing all the cells so that all that's left is like the extracellular matrix scaffold, and then you just grow new cells around the pre-existing ECM. But you've seen the title, so it's time to talk about the cell scaffold that'll leave you crumbfounded. At the start of COVID, scientists around the globe were suddenly unable to go into their research labs, finding themselves at home, and they did all the classic quarantine 1.0 things that a lot of us did. They downloaded House Party, they arbitrarily assumed this would be over by September, I guess. They deleted House Party when they realized how it had major privacy issues, and they baked bread. Gazing at the bubbly inside of their freshly baked accomplishment, a few researchers from the Uni of Ottawa were inspired. They'd been working on developing different scaffolds for cell growth and immediately recognized this porous crumb as being full of potential. Some experimenters conversation later and it was revealed that it wasn't just a half-baked idea. Turns out Irish-style soda bread, which uses sodium bicarbonate as a rising agent rather than yeast, hence why it's called soda bread, makes a pretty cracking cell scaffold. All you need to do is bake the bread, cut out little discs that are about this big, and add some chemicals to make the scaffold a little more sturdy. Now this final sturdy chemical adding step isn't necessarily needed, it's just that when you grow cells, you submerge them, along with their scaffold, into what's called a growth medium, a cocktail of all tasty things that they need to grow. Non-chemically sturdied bread does get a bit soggier, but it was still shown to be able to grow cells, so. Now this is a very early study, but bread as a cell scaffold could mean that whilst labs would require more dough, they may need less dough. In non-pun terms, I basically mean that it could vastly reduce the cost associated with growing cells, which could then potentially make the process of studying cell growth far more accessible, which is a win. Growing cells can be useful for all sorts of different fields. The purpose isn't always to like grow a whole new organ, like I mentioned at the start. Sometimes it's just useful to have a sample of cells to test different drugs on, for example. The researchers on the study do admit that a lot more research is needed before the bread scaffold could have clinical uses, i.e. medical uses, but they do point out that it is ready made to be great for the lab-grown meat industry. There are already lab meat scaffolds that contribute to the texture of the fake meat itself, like textured soy protein and cellulose, and maybe then little soda bread discs could be one of those too. You'd like have your breadcrumbs inside your fake chicken instead of on the outside. It'd be like an inverted sandwich. But yeah, I love that little bit of lockdown-inspired innovation, especially because it means that a good chunk of the scientific paper that the researchers wrote about it is just a recipe for soda bread. It still gets to the point quicker than most online recipes I've seen though, to be honest. But that's it for now though, everyone. So please do like this video if you like it, share it if you share it, subscribe it if you subscribe it, and comment with your best use for bread. I don't know, get creative. All that's left to say then is thank you so much for watching, have a lovely day, and remember, if you think you've got an innovative idea for a cell scaffold, crush yourself and bag it. It's the yeast you can do. A ginormous thank you to my wonderful patrons with a special new shout out. Hello to Sam, new patron, and also a kumi to Justin, Terry, Brent, Dhruv and Angela. Like bag it, like put it in the bag of your thoughts, but also baguette, like the bread. I started my scientific career in 1964 when I first ate bread, also grown. Are you ready? Are you ready for love? Yes I am, oh yeah. The scaffold. I think I'm gonna start being like, oh, it's the best thing since cell scaffolds. And then people be like, what are you on about? And then I can be like, watch my video. I don't think that made any sense. That's the end of the video. Congrats, you made it. Here's a single video. Here's a playlist of videos. And here's a Patreon link. All right, bye.